Many people have a hard time getting good photos of their drawings, but this short video should help. You won't need an expensive camera or Photoshop or any expensive editing programs either. You'll be able to get really good results with just your cell phone and a free app. I'll start off with things you can do while you're taking the photo, because the better this is to begin with, the easier it's going to be to use the app to fine-tune it. The first thing you should do is go to your camera settings and select the highest quality resolution available. You'll probably do this by clicking on a little gear icon after you open up your camera. You'll also have much better results with this if you turn off your flash. Next, lay your drawing flat in an area that has good lighting that's as even as possible. The first thing you should try to do is to square up the image. You don't want to take your picture off from the side or down below because that will distort your drawing. So move your camera to the center of the piece of paper and keep it parallel to the drawing surface. If your camera has a grid setting, which adds horizontal and vertical lines on the screen, it can make it a little bit easier to do this part. After you think you're squared up, then either get closer or zoom in to fill the frame with your drawing. We want to make your drawing as large as possible on this photo. Don't snap the picture just yet. There's a few other things that we need to do. One of the biggest problems when photographing a drawing is a lot of times it just has a plain white background. And if you leave your phone on automatic settings, your phone is reading that white background and it's saying, "This is way too bright. We've got to darken this down." So you take that picture and all of that white paper appears much darker. And a lot of times colors even creep in. So regardless if you're using an iPhone, an Android, a Pixel, or any other phone camera, there is a setting on the camera to change the exposure. On most cameras, this is done simply by tapping your finger on the screen, and a little slider will come up that will allow you to brighten or darken the image. Now, don't go overboard with brightening the image here, because that will result in a photograph that's completely blown out. You'll miss all the subtle shading in your drawing. With a photograph that's completely blown out like that, all that information is missing from the digital file, and you could never get it back. So it's actually better to take several exposures to have a variety of photos to work with. Once we get to the second part of this tutorial, you'll see some other methods that we'll use to brighten up the paper and get rid of the colors that may have creeped in. Another thing I should mention here is that you can also tap and hold your finger on the screen to open up what is called the focus and exposure lock. That feature can be handy if you want to make sure that certain areas of your drawing are exposed correctly. I've had good results just using this method though, as long as I make sure I get quite a few different exposures to choose from once I put it into the app. Now that you've taken some photos with different exposures, let's move on to downloading and using this really cool app called Snapseed. When you do a search for Snapseed on the App Store or the Google Play Store, you'll see this logo. You'll also need to give the app permission to have access to your photos. After it's downloaded onto your phone, click the little icon to open it up. Then tap anywhere on the screen to open up all the photos you just took. But before you click on any photo, I suggest you go into settings with an idea of what you want to do with this photo once you have it just right. So click on these three dots in the upper right corner and click on settings. This is where you'll decide what you'll be using this photo for. The larger the image size, the better the quality. So if you plan on printing it out or sending it to somebody and having them print it out, click Do Not Resize. If you're just going to post it online or email it to somebody for them to look at on their computer, choose a smaller size. Next, under Format and Quality, make sure that the JPEG is set to 100% if you're going to print it out. For non-print uses, click on Format and Quality and select a lower percentage. Okay, now let's get out of settings by clicking this back arrow up here. Then tap anywhere on the screen to open up all of the photos you just took. As I mentioned before, don't choose one that has totally white paper or you'll be missing a lot of the subtle details in the shading on your drawing. Don't pick one that's extremely dark either because it'll make your job a little bit harder going forward. After you choose your photo, this is what it looks like. Now you'll see a bunch of presets down there, but none of those will do us any good at all for trying to make this photo look like your drawing. So the first thing I suggest you do is click on Tools and then choose Black and White to get rid of all that color. At this point, you have a couple options for how you want this black and white image to look. I suggest you just stick with neutral. None of these other options will help it look like your drawing. To accept this change and any other future changes, you'll click this check mark. If at any time you don't like what you just did, push the back button to undo that change. In case you didn't get totally squared up when you were shooting these photos, let me show you a handy tool to fix that. Again, you'll go to Tools and then Perspective. From here, you'll just slide your finger up and down or back and forth to fix any perspective issues you may still have. Now the only thing left to do is work a little bit on the lighting issues we have with this drawing. One of the tools you'll probably end up using the most with this app is the brightness, contrast, saturation, that sort of thing. Even though those toggles aren't going to fix this image, I'll show you where to find them and how to use them at this point. You'll find brightness and contrast controls by clicking Tools, then Tune Image. Then by moving your finger up and down, you'll toggle through brightness, contrast, saturation, and some other settings. After you choose the setting you want to change, then you move your finger back and forth on the screen. For instance, for brightness, it will get brighter if I slide my finger to the right, and darker if I slide my finger to the left. But that's not really going to help us with our problem here, because by the time I get the bottom of this picture bright enough, the top of it is going to be too bright, and it's also removing all the lighter, subtle values I have in the skin tones. So those Tune Image toggles work well if you need to change the overall brightness or contrast or things like that on the image globally. But an image like this that has uneven lighting, we have to go about it a different way. So let's begin by clicking that back button to get out of the brightness settings. And then we're going to click Selective from the Tools menu. And what this will do is allow us to select the areas that we want to change the brightness and contrast rather than doing it to the entire image. Since this photo is darker on the bottom than it is on the top, I'll begin by tapping on a bottom corner where I know I need to have it brighter. This brings up the little letter B. And that's there because right now this is set on brightness. So if you swipe your finger up or down anywhere on your screen, it gives you the options for brightness, contrast, saturation, and structure. We're going to use brightness, so we'll leave it set on that. Now when you swipe your finger back and forth on the screen, you'll see that swiping to the right makes it brighter. Swiping to the left makes that area darker. Let's set this back to zero now, though, because we can fine-tune this to be even more accurate. If you use two fingers or a thumb and a finger to pinch and zoom, like you do when you're going to zoom in when you're taking a photograph, you can make that area that we're working on either larger or smaller. And that's represented by this circle here. I want to make sure that that area that I'm brightening doesn't encroach on the subject and make it too bright. So when I pinch my fingers together, that little circle will get smaller. When you think you have it the right size, slide your finger back and forth to brighten or darken that area. To add another selection, just press the plus button and then tap wherever you want to make those adjustments. Now that circle that designates our selection there has a very soft, feathered edge to help make a gradual transition between those places where you're trying to adjust and those where you're not. That means if you're not careful, you can end up brightening parts of your drawing that you don't want to. So I find it better to have more small overlapping sections rather than just a few big ones to get the most even adjustments. I suggest you make your selections even smaller than what I've done here in this demonstration. When you think you have all of those darker areas bright enough, and you're pretty confident you haven't brightened places that you don't want to, click the check mark to save those changes. The other thing that needs to be done with this image is to crop it to make the drawing fill up the frame more. By the way, you could have cropped this earlier in the process too. So you'll just click Tools and Crop. And you'll do this just by dragging your finger along the lines to make the image the size that you want. then click the check mark to save the changes. Now, after you crop it, you may notice that you could still do a little bit more brightening in certain areas. So just go back to Tools, Selective, and work on those areas like you did before. Again, just make sure that that selection circle is small enough that it isn't going to brighten areas that you don't want it to. I'm sure you've noticed that in the Tools menu, there's a lot more options than what I've shown you here. So I suggest you experiment with these tools a little bit, because the more you familiarize yourself with this app, the better you'll get at it. I should also mention that there are a lot of different ways to achieve the same result. Now, once you're happy with how you've made this photo look much more like your drawing, the next thing to do is save it. And to do that, you click on Export. From there, click on how you want to save the photo or who you want to share it with. I hope you found this helpful. Let me know in the comments if you know of some other ways you can use this app to get a more accurate representation of what your drawings look like. That's it for now. Keep drawing.